Your home is FS1 and Fox all week long, leading up to Manny Pacquiao against Keith Thurman, with pressers, weigh-ins, and of course a pair of title fights as well on Saturday night on July 20th. Welcome back. Two fighters, zero losses. Caleb Plant and Mike Lee are here before their championship bout July 20th on Fox. Good to see you both. How are you doing?
Thanks for having me.
Good. Got to talk about this a second, because neither of you are wearing socks. Sean was wearing socks today.
I had to change
a bad
them.
Choice of pair of socks.
Where'd he go?
Chicken?
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah.
He has some surprise.
Now let's get to the interview.
Okay, guys, what's at stake for the two of you in this fight? Caleb, you go first. You're the champ.
I think we've kind of come to terms, both of us, with what's at stake. For him, he says he has nothing to lose, but for me, I have everything to lose. This is my life's work coming down to one moment, July 20th. It's an accumulation of basically my whole life, 18 years. Right over 18 years to be exact, come July 20th. So I know what's at risk, I know what's at stake, and I'm prepared to do whatever it takes to keep that belt.
It's Mike's first fight at super middleweight. You've always fought at light heavyweight at 175. You're coming down all those pounds. Did you feel like he deserved this title fight at this point in time?
For me, I don't really focus on who's deserving and who's not deserving. They come to me with fights, and I say yes. So Peter Quillin and Caleb Truax, they weren't able to get things figured out with the incident that happened in their fight. I'm looking to stay busy. I'm the champ. I don't feel like I should have to wait on anybody. I was inactive last year because of my hand. And this is who they brought. This is a bigger guy coming down. He's undefeated. He's looking to stay that way. And well, we're going to find out for sure.
Mike, the Subway guy. I got to ask you, though.
I can't get rid of that.
No, you won't. Not on this show.
Is that good to know?
But I got to ask, why don't you feel like you have anything to lose?
I mean, because I feel like I'm the underdog in this. I know I'm the B-side, you know, and all the press conferences that we've had so far, yeah, we got a little heated, but right off the bat, I said, I got respect for Caleb. I got respect for anybody that stepped in the ring, you know what I mean? Especially guys who won a championship. But this is about business, and I know that they want me to lose. I know I'm the B-side. So I got to come into it with that mentality that I will do anything. You're going to have to carry me out of that damn ring. And I'll do anything July 20th to win. So that's kind of the mindset that I have going into it.
And the move down to super middleweight, is that a business decision?
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, when I found out that we had a chance to fight for a world title, I said yes.
Yeah, you take those opportunities, of course.
I had to take the opportunity, and I was so excited. I mean, I said earlier, I literally started crying when I got that phone call. I mean, it's been a dream of mine since I was 8 years old, laced up gloves for the first time. I mean, this is the culmination, just like Caleb said, of all the years of hard work, pain, sacrifice, scars on my body. And, you know, it's all for one night. And it's a beautiful thing. And I feel blessed to be here, grateful. And I'm putting everything I got into it.
You've talked about the fact that you're completely comfortable with the weight cut. You've kind of made out like it's a non-issue. Have you done anything specifically to practice that? Have you practiced weight cuts?
Yeah, so we've hired a few new sports scientists and nutritionists. So, to be honest, I surround myself with smarter people than me. And so I'm trying to put them around me, and they're telling me exactly what to eat, what to put in my body, and I just have to trust them. I mean, my last fight, I weighed in at 173, and I felt good. I feel like 168 won't be an issue, because you need to make 68 the day before, and then 78 because of the sanctioning body. And after that, I can continue to hydrate and move up. So I don't see it as a disadvantage. I see it as an advantage. And why would I look at it any other way, you know?
Now, Caleb, are you concerned about him not making weight, coming in bigger? I mean, do you see him as a bigger man? What's his strengths? What are his weaknesses?
His biggest weakness is that he's fighting me. But besides that, I don't look at him being bigger than me or his sports nutritionist that he has or the scientists that are on his team, because they can't throw his punches for him. Come fight night, it's me and him in the ring. Not his nutritionist, not his dad, not anybody else but me and him. I've been bred to do this my whole life. I've been doing this my whole life. It's the only thing I've been doing my whole life. No distractions, no other avenues or roads, only boxing.
Now, let's talk about the stage, because you guys are leading into the pay-per-view fight card. Now, Caleb, the last fight, we saw a lot of explosion, a lot of power, a lot of improvements. You were fast, quick on your feet. You were able to make Uzaki, whatever his name is, miss. Uzagidi, make him miss. Did I mess it up again?
Yeah. Uzagidi.
Jose.
Jose. What can we expect from you against Mike Lee?
You can expect a better and improved Caleb. Every time you guys see me out, you see a better improved Caleb. Come July 20th, you'll see a better improved Caleb. My strength, my speed, my footwork, everything. It'll be on a new level, just like you see it every other fight.
What do you see in Caleb's game that you feel that you can take advantage of?
Well, to be honest, like I said earlier, obviously when we got the call, I said yes right away. And I hadn't seen too many of the other fights. But I've said this since day one. If I'm the best Mike Lee in the ring, I'm not worried about anybody else. I have what it takes. I know I have the power, the strength, the speed, the size to do it. And so for me, it's not being concerned about him or what he says or even the sports nutritionist or anything like that. When the bell rings, I got to be the best me I can be. And that's what I'm super confident in.
You shake your head. Why? Because you don't buy it or because you just think it doesn't matter knowing what you feel?
Because the best Mike Lee will still fall short. It doesn't matter how much he comes in. It doesn't matter how well he's prepared. I've been doing this my whole life. Is he going to outbox me? No. Is he going to rough me up like Jose did? No. Is he going to beat me here or here? No. He can't beat me. That's it. Plain and simple. He cannot beat me. That's a fact.
I love it. I love hearing that. You know, I want him to feel that way the entire time, underestimate me. I'm going to work my ass off and come out there and, like I said, give it everything I have. So I'm happy he has that attitude.
I don't say that because he's underestimated. You don't overlook the overlooked. That's why I'm here. I was overlooked in my last fight. Guess what happened?
Guys, we got to fight. We got to fight.
Yeah.
I'm not underestimating him. He can't beat me not because I'm underestimating him. He can't beat me because he's not good enough to beat me. He hasn't been doing this his whole life. He has plan B, he has plan C, he has plan D. I have plan A. My whole life I've only had plan A. No other bridges. The water gets deep, he'll bow out at some point. And I'm bank on it. Tune in July 20th and see. You'll know exactly what I'm saying.
On that note, we do have to go to a break, so we're going to have to wrap it up. Guys, it was great to see you. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you for watching. Well, if you enjoyed that clip, make sure you click somewhere around here and subscribe. From fight highlights to exclusive interviews, we have got everything you need as a boxing fan right here on PBC on Fox.